Hello there, welcome to Temporal Paradox 1. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create an automated slideshow using Vegas Movie Studio HD Platinum 10. Please note that this feature is only available in this version of Movie Studio. If you have Movie Studio 987, you will not find it. And also, if you have the Pro version, you will not find this plugin. It's only in Movie Studio. So to get going, hit the Insert, then Slideshow, and there's the plugin. Before you go any further, always make sure that you've set your project properties before starting to place stuff into the timeline. Because if you start off with a low quality setting, put everything in, and then change it to HD at the end, it can make some weird stuff happen, okay? So try and remember to do that first. Now, Slideshow Creator. Click Add Pictures. Then navigate through your computer to find the pictures that you want to use. Remember a little tool in Windows. If you just want to pick out, not every photo in a row, you can hold the Control key down and do this to select photographs. Okay? But I want to select everything, so I'm holding the Shift button down. First one, last one, it selects everything in between. Open. Okay, now I'll hit on top of one of them and you'll notice straight away that some of these icons suddenly lit up. The first one just gives you the ability to rotate a photograph. So, you know, sometimes when you take a photograph it's positioned the wrong way, so you can fix that up now. If you want to change the position the photograph appears in the slideshow, just drag it into a new position like that. There's also some tools here for sorting or shuffling the photographs, but I'm sure you can work that out yourself. The main settings is in the settings tab. First choice you have here is either start. This is asking where do you want the project to be placed, where the cursor is, or at a particular point. So if I wanted the project to start at the 1 minute mark, I don't have to click that actually. All I have to do is click that and type in 1, which is what I'm going to do. Next level is duration. How long does the slide that each individual photograph stay on the screen for? So the default setting is 3 seconds. You can make that whatever you want. There's also a feature here on the next line where you may have a gap in a project that lasts for, you know, any sort of amount of time, and you want a certain amount of photos to display evenly during that time gap. That's when you can use this tool here by typing in the amount of time, okay? But I'm just going to use the simple setting for this example. And then finally is where you can do lots of mucking around and find out what you want. And it's the effects window here. By default it uses random, but if you open that up there's many different settings you can choose. So if I start off with something simple, fades of pan, and then click create, first thing you'll notice it's dumped it in at the 1 minute mark as I specified. Let's play through a little bit. And it's just doing a simple pan and fade between each photograph. Okay, but if you don't like that and you want to get a bit more advanced, just press Control Z. That'll undo that. Change the setting here to something different, press create. And now we've got some random transitions. Let's do something different again. This time we can change the length of time that the photograph displays, increase the overlap, and let's do random pan and zoom. Create. So it's lasting a lot longer now, and the transition's lasting a little bit longer as well. So I think you get the point by now. So when you're happy with that, just click it off, and Bob's your uncle. But if you want to do one last little thing, then you can do some manual tweaks. So I'm just going to expand into the timeline a bit so I can see more clearly. If there's a particular transition you're not happy with, then you can always hit the Transitions tab. And like on this first one here, you don't like this effect, So just simply pick the one you want and drop it on top, and it will override the one that was already in there, and you can see straight away that it's changed it. Okay, the other thing you can change is in the panning and zooming. Pan and zoom is always generated by the event pan and crop button, so we'll click that, and that movement you're seeing generated is because of keyframes. Keyframes are marker points in time, and it's telling Vegas to shift this particular frame from that starting point to a new point. Okay, if you like a particular pattern that the event pan and crop has created and you want to apply it to some of the other photographs to keep some sort of consistency, if you don't like random, then you can copy the keyframes and transfer them. To do that, click on top of the checkerboard area, drag to the left, and as I do that, notice that there's a dotted line appearing. Let go back into the middle of it, right click, copy, and that's now copied these two keyframes with the position of the actual frame. So I'll click that off. Now if I go along here, and where are we? On this one here, I want to apply the same effect. Now I'm just going to roll in a bit more until the icon appears. Click it. Right click on top and paste. Then if I play through, I'll just do it. It's changed the zoom. Okay, so you can do stuff like that as well. That's basically it. Always remember, if you've mucked something up big time, just keep pressing Control Z or Control Z, as some people say, and you can keep going backwards in time. So I hope that was helpful. Thanks for watching, thanks for listening, and stay tuned for a follow-up tutorial where I'll show you how to create the exact same project but 100% yourself, the old-fashioned manual way, if you want complete control.